Hello, and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Sean Stevens, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, helping you make your game nights better. Today, I'm here to talk about Dubious, a game about trying to determine who the other players are and who's lying. This is from Arcane Wonders and is a kind of social deduction role-playing party game where you are given a role and a secret, and you are trying to play that role up by answering questions while the other players are trying to guess who's who, and you want some people to get it right, but not everyone. Step one to playing the game, though, is going to be cutting the shrink on this copy of the game. And I got to say right off the bat, it's something I found amusing, is board games that feature artwork on their cover and don't have the name always bothered me. And obviously Arcane Wonders saw the problem because this is a sticker that was put on the front. Like the name of the game's on the sides. Now, before I continue, I do have to thank Arcane Wonders for sending me home from Origins 2019 with a review copy of this game. So we did get to take this home. This is a review copy. So thank you, Arcane Wonders. We're about to crack the shrink on Dubious. And here you can see what I was talking about. If I saw this on a game shelf, I wouldn't know what it is. It is striking, though. I got to say, the artwork pops. It pops really well. So we're going to crack open Dubious for the first time. Very black box. We have the game rules. Doubt is in the air. Why would anyone be doubting anyone? No one has anything to hide here. We have the game components. It's not going to be a lot to look at. Again, striking, though. There's something about the contrast of this that really pops. You got some like DM screen style things where you're going to hide some info, some sheets you're going to do some writing on, and a bunch of cards. How to set up the game, how to play. Game end. So your total actual rules are 3 pages here. That's it. This should be a pretty quick to learn game with a lot of gameplay that I think is going to be very player driven. Here is the pad. We're going to check for one of the things I like. Yes. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Arcane Wonders, for two-sided pads of paper. I've never understood. Now, I will point out, unfortunately, my copy here has just got a little bit bent. Now, these are just thin paper. I'm sure you can get more online. Not a huge thing, but I do have to call it out because it was kind of sticking out of the bottom. So we also have a bunch of clips because you are going to clip these to your boards to be able to write on them. We have the screens to hide what's going on. And then the board you're going to clip things to. It looks like all the screens are the same. Yes. So we have a bunch of identical screens. I'm going to try to slide just one out and leave the rest of these bound. So there, this is basically kind of gives you the phases of the game and how it works, as well as a scoring overview at the end of the game. And very flimsy, little disappointing. Would like that a little thicker, but it'll work. This is just, you're going to put this up so no one can see the notes you're taking on the pad, which I probably should show off the pad a little bit. Here's where you're going to put your name, your role, how many people guessed you, how many people guessed your secret. This is where you're going to write down your answers to the 5 questions you were asked. And here's where you're going to take notes on the other players, who you think they are. So that's a quick overview of that. Again, this is not meant to be a full teach. Then we have the more useful list of roles and secrets. It's, of course, one of the first pieces of the deduction of this game is, well, if I'm the war mage, I know no one else can. And I got to point this out. If you look, you have executioner, war mage, berserker. This would be the fantasy set. There should be 6 of these, 1 for each player. And then we have the hairstylist, taxi driver, paramedic, modern characters. And then we have the mailman, tailor, coachman, chemist, magician. Well, this would be steampunk or Victorian London, whichever way you want to go with on this one. And then, of course, the secret. So these are the boards. You would take these at the beginning. We have various cards. I'm not sure if these are our roles or secrets. These are the roles. So here we have the role cards. Again, they're going to be split up into the different eras. Oddly, they're not sorted now, which is a little weird. So you have the executioner, the stableman, the rogue, and then some of the secrets are mixed in. Yeah, so these are just mixed. I'm convinced that magic doesn't exist from the fantasy one. So one of the first things you have to do before you play this is sort the cards, which is easy enough. You're just going to split, like I'm going to start doing it here, and you know, here's those. These are fantasy secrets. These are purple. And you're going to sort the cards. And I got to say, Very striking artwork again. I do really appreciate it. Like, I purchased a cursed sword. Like, look at the picture of the cursed sword. That's actually really nice art for something. These could have been text. And I do like the look of the invisible people. None of the people have heads. This person also has a very odd hand. None of the people have heads, you can see. Which I like it. It sticks with the same aesthetic. I like to sleep in a coffin. So you basically have two packs of those. So, oh no, these are the question cards. Okay. So these would be all of the secrets and the rolls. And there are 14 secrets and 14 rolls for each of the three periods. And we have question cards. And there's various types of questions. I think, oh no, there's even some rolls. Okay, these cards are just mixed up. I have some question cards. And then more roll and secret cards. So a bunch more of these to sort through. Again, there you have the capitalist, the coachman. I'm a kleptomaniac. So you could be the coachman who's also a kleptomaniac. I've got pet snakes. I do. I really like the art in this. It's very striking for something that literally could just be the word. This could say it just in big bold letters, traitor, and the game would work just as well. I dig it. So we're going to put those in the middle. These would be the questions. You're going to get asked five questions every turn, like, what is your favorite game? And there are different categories of these questions that you're going to put together, like based on your appearance. If you look, that's a mirror. And based on your appearance, you're going to get, what do your hands look like? And you're going to answer based on your role. And again, the goal is to have some people guess the right role, but not everyone. Last thing in here, our friend of the show, Red Meeple Myron, would appreciate a bunch of markers, pencils. And interesting, they're actually black pencil crayons or colored pencils, as we say here in Canada, with erasers on them. There is six of these so tightly packed, I can't even get it open. So you can see them there. Very black, again, fitting with the theme. With erasers, which I'm sure probably won't last as long as you'd like them to. They're pre-sharpened, so you can play this out of the box. No sharpener, though. It even shows you how to sort it. So you're supposed to sort your three different time periods, it looks like here. And then up here, yeah, okay. So you put your time periods, sort by three. You put your questions here. And I don't know, paper clips probably fit in here. Decent enough box insert. It'll work. Card could have been thicker. But it's odd because they obviously spent the money on the artwork instead of on the component, like on the cardboard. Publisher Hobby World, interestingly, because we got this one from Arcane Wonders. 2022 Hobby World. So it looks like it might be Arcane Wonders localized this one in North America. So there you have it. What you get in the box with Dubious from Arcane Wonders, or is it Hobby World? I'm not even sure now. Maybe they were playing the game when they published this one, but it looks like it's actually from both. So that is my look at what you get in the box for Dubious, a character role playing, but I don't mean like RPG, you level up, you kill monsters, but a play a role, try to convince people who you are, while not giving everything away. You have a role and a secret, and you need some of the players to guess it, but not all the players, and you are trying to do the same for the other players. You're trying to guess each of their roles and secrets. Interesting party-style game for 3 to 6 players that I am looking forward to checking out. Seems nice and quick play, 30 minutes. Lots of different questions to go through and lots of different roles. Appreciate the fact there's 3 different eras to play in, which is going to be great depending on who I play with. Like, if I'm playing with family, I'm probably going to grab the modern, but if I'm playing with my old RPG group, I'm going to grab that fantasy one because I think that looks fantastic. Card art. Way better than it needs to be, like shockingly, like check out how striking that is. And all of the characters are like that. They you can kind of see on the back too. They have no heads. They're like all the Invisible Man, which I just thought was neat because that way you don't have to worry about like if they're old, young, gender or any of that. That's a nice way to present it. I appreciate that. Totally unnecessary. And I thought it was really cool because the cards could have just had text on them. Little disappointed by the thickness of the player boards, the like DM screens that hide the information. They seem like they'd easily blow over if someone like barely took a breath. But I haven't tried it yet. Maybe they're better than they look. I would have liked them being a little bit thicker. The player cards being thin is fine because that's going to be flat. That's not going to be something sit up. So looks pretty cool to me. That is Dubious. And no, I am not Sean Stevens. I might have fooled you all, though I doubt it. I am Motuzino, the Tabletop Bellhop. You can find at tabletopbellhop.com, all over the internet as Tabletop Bellhop, one word, and through the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. Looking forward to digging into Dubious. May even get this one played this weekend. When I do so, I will be sharing reviews on YouTube, on Twitch, and on the blog eventually, so you'll be able to read it, watch it, or listen to it, whatever you prefer. Thank you for joining me for this unmasking of Dubious from Arcane Wonders and Hobby World. Sorry, I forgot about the Hobby World thing. Thank you, Arcane Wonders, because they're the ones that hooked me up.